wear your shirt. It all began when I was only 3 and a half years of age. I was half a year away to turning 4. I had the dream of climbing up a mountain, but not just any plain old mountain. No, the mountain that was shown in a logo that plays before any movie. Long before I settled on migrating here. The problem is, my parents didn't know that. My parents didn't think climbing that mountain was possible. Mommy, what's this mountain called?
That's called Artesonraju. I've been there on a field trip once.
It sounds hard to say.
Yeesh, right there. You couldn't pronounce it the same way you did.
Someday, I'm gonna climb that mountain.
Dingus, aren't you a little young to be climbing mountains?
Age doesn't matter, Daddy.
When I was younger, I used to dream of being a gardener. But then I got a job as a grocery store employee as a school project.
Well, as time passed by, my parents still didn't understand.
Son, aren't you supposed to be doing your chores? This room is a mess.
What's the point of doing chores, Dad? When I have something better planned in my mind.
What an Arctic name are you talking about, Stuart?
Who could not deny the heart that is yearning for the dream to come true. I want to climb that mountain from that logo.
Dear, he keeps on dreaming again.
He just needs to accept the fact that it's just too far away. Son, we just want to say that this particular mountain is just too many miles out of your reach.
Trust me, I'll get there. For such a long time, my parents thought I wanted to go somewhere warmer. You know what, they're right. I've always wanted to go to Delaware. It was actually the very first state in America. Besides, being born on an island that's nothing but snow and minus 85 degrees Fahrenheit is a complete waste of temperature. That's just great. I can't open this. Anyone have any opposable fingers or thumbs?
No.
Just flippers? Fine then.
Hey, watch it, Bob.
Goodbye, Mom and Dad. It's a really good thing I remember your phone numbers.
That's nice to hear, Dinguskins.
You know, we were very proud of you growing up. And I'm glad you made the right decision.
Come on, Dingus. I haven't done all day, you know.
Will my dream of climbing that mountain ever come true?
Probably not.
That was the very last time I got to see everything when I knew from Antarctica, even my parents.
What about the dream, Dingus?
Face it, Gilbert, I probably will never achieve that dream. It was the dream of climbing up the mountain from that logo. That dream was practically shattered after I migrated.
Oh, very well. Do you feel okay, buddy?
Me? Oh, I ended up feeling great. I never felt better in my whole life. You want to arm wrestle? I'll get it, bub. Oh, it's you, Bill. What brings you here?
I've been meaning to tell you something. I suppose you can like this.
And they are.
I overheard your dream, so I feel like lifting your spirits up. One of my friends is a plane driver.
You mean he'll take me to the mountain I wanted to climb?
Yippity yippity yip.
Oh, can I come along too?
I don't see why not. Trying to get somewhere, so I can achieve my dream.
Oh, so you and your friend are travelers, I suppose?
Not Really? But I suppose you can take us there.
Peru, to be exact.
Where he wants to go is to Artesonraju.
Anda!
What is this old plane made out of then? I'm pretty sure it was latex.
The engine combusted. I really think I should settle on a different type of engine that's more stable.
I think we're here.
Not exactly what I imagined, Peru. Anyway, we need to find this mountain so I can climb it. What was it called again? What was it called? Artesonraju.
Come on, buddy. How difficult can it be?
Gilbert, I completely give up. It's just helpless. I have a feeling that mountain was a huge fake. Wait, where are you? Face it, Gilbert. There's no such thing as Artesonraju. My mind is tricking me. So, just to reiterate what my plan is, we're climbing up there to achieve my dream.
Yup.
We should set up a base camp.
That's not a bad idea, Dingus. For you.
I hate to ask this, Gilbert, but where do you put all that stuff?
You'll never know, Dingus. Look, I've seen that constellation before. It's that of Orion.
Did I ever mention that I still remember my parents' phone number?
I suppose parenting does things to you.
Wait, what if I become a father with a wife and five siblings? All right, how about a bottle? Don't worry, how about a kiss?
In fact, if I didn't find his pitiful sobbing so amusing, I'd come out there and rip your limbs off.
I'm shocked and appalled. Why are you crying? Look, Mutt, you cannot destroy my baby daughter's pretty purse. Well, I pooped on it. I'll pick it up. Well, can you pick up your own excrement yourself? Are you dense? I can't pick that up. Are you the one who is dense? Well, I'm not picking up dog poop. Look, bub, don't make me stop this game and come out there. What game? I don't want to think that'd be my Australian relative at my door.
Good thing I'm not wearing tight pants, because they would have ripped for sure.
What's her problem? Oh, I forgot to pay the electric bill.
Seems like he's giving you a pink belly, Dad.
Pink bellies? I hated those. To this day, I hate those. Curse you, man!
I think it's best if I didn't become a father, Gilbert.
Okay, then. Show it yourself.
Wait a minute, Bill. Never mind.
What on earth is he doing there?
He's on the moon again. Anyway, good night, Gilbert.
The summer wind came blowing in from across the sea. It lingered there to touch your hair and walk with me. All summer long, we sang a song, and then we strolled that golden sand. Two sweethearts and the summer wind, like painted kites, those days and nights, they went flying by. The world was new beneath the blue umbrella sky. Then softer than a piper man, one day it called to you. I lost you, lost you to the summer wind. The autumn wind and the winter winds, they have come and gone. And still the days, those lonely days, they go on and on. And guess who sings his lullabies through nights that never end? My fickle friend, the summer wind. Summer wind, warm summer wind, the summer wind.
Rise and shine, friend.
That was very unnecessary, Gilbert.
I'm sorry, Dingus, but I woke up early. And I was very eager to wake you up, too. Anyway, I made breakfast.
Well, that makes sense. I can't go climbing at Artesonraju on an empty stomach.
I made you waffle slices and mashed sausage.
All right. Judging by my capabilities of being a penguin, I think we might be safer if we head up the side where it's more snowy.
Good eye, Dingus. Why in the world is it colder here, even though it's 85 degrees?
I have no clue. All I don't know is that you must picture yourself somewhere soft and warm. Put yourself in my feathers for a second and you'll see.
I'll try. I can't come up with any. It's just too hard to imagine somewhere warm.
Gilbert, you go first.
I can't, because, I have a bad feeling something horrible might happen.
All right, fine, you giant baby.
Oh, that's because I still wear a diaper. Is that so?
I'm too heavy. There's a humongous crack on the ice.
This could become a problem. No, wait. I have an idea.
I didn't know you were so light and strong, Gilbert.
The good thing is that you're safe.
You know, I'm kind of scared.
Don't worry, Dingus. I'm right here with you.
I'm kind of amazed at how you have the ability to get and keep everything inside you. What are you, some kind of marsupial?
I was prepared. You can do this, Dings. If you want to achieve your dream, then it's yours.
You're right. And when you're right, you're right. I'm glad you're here to encourage me. I just hope I can make the young child inside of me happy. Okay, I take what I said back. I don't think I can do this. The reason why I came here to do this is because I wanted to achieve my dream to climb this mountain.
And just when I thought things couldn't get any better, my friend decides to suddenly give up and quit.
Don't give up on it, buddy. Look inside yourself. There's a little voice inside you saying you need to do it.
I'm sorry I doubted you.
You don't know how much you mean to me, Chuck.
Hey, look! The very top of Artesonraju. I can see it. It's just a few measly feet away. We're almost there.
Well, we did it, Bonnie.
We did it. We climbed up Artesonraju, and now we're all the way up to the very top. There. I can't.
That may stand speechless, huh?
Yes. Are you that dense in the head, Gilbert? I made my dream come true. I only wish, if only Bill would see this moment.
Life has been a wonderful, peaceful dream. Hello, little fella.
Isn't this wonderful? I can see everything from all the way up here. Even that old plane.
Hey, plane driver! How does he know that? Anyway, this wants to take months to repair this old thing.
I wish this whole moment would last forever.
I wish that too, but that's just impossible. Anyways, I'm so proud of myself. I had to never give up.
I feel like it's so much fun to slide down there.
I don't know about that. Hey, come back here, you rascal. I beat you.
That was so much fun, buddy.
Come on, pal. Let's head home.
Why not? Hey, I know something that rhymes with plane.
I never imagined how magical the world is. As someone once said, this world truly is a carousel of color.
I think this whole trip wasn't so bad after all.
You know, bud, my head goes off to you. I actually just wanted to thank you, buddy, for helping me achieve my dream, making it come true.
I want to thank you, too, for letting me come with you.
And there were a lot of moments that I'd like to share, but there's a lot.
We're off on the road to Artesonraju. That name is quite hard to say.
I pronounced it right.
Where we go, why we go, no one understands. But we made sure that we both washed our mitts, known as hands. Did we? We're off on the road to Artesonraju. We always go our own way.
At least we hope.
I feel this is a magical land, so serene and sweet. Oh yes, we'd tell you more, but we would have the censors on our feet. Amen. We certainly do get around. Like Webster's Dictionary, we're Artesonraju bound.
I feel all tingly inside.
You can say that again.
Oh, you're crazy.
We're off on the road to Artesonraju. There's no stopping us. Here we come. We may face hints of danger, but we'll never fear.
That's right.
Cause our creator still cares about us for many more years. I hope we are off on the road to Artesonraju. The home of the famous movie Peak. We walk together as a team.
More
than a giraffe. At least we have some unique ways to making people laugh.
Oh, sure,
we certainly do get around. Like Webster's Dictionary, we're Artesonraju bound.
One last time, buddy.
Take it home! We're Artesonraju bound!
What's wrong? What are you trying to say?
Nothing. It's just very cold in here.
Shirt.